My name is Kemal Erkan. I'm the chairman of American Surgery Center, and I have Dr. Isaias Irgau with me, our president for CREAS. I also want to kind of discuss the pandemic and still, like, although we got our vaccine, and I think now we are at 52% of the Americans, they got at least one.
Yep, that's great.
And then the state of Delaware is doing very well. I had my, just recently I met with Governor Carney, and he is committed to make this even better. And that's my understanding.
That's great.
From him, and which is really good, but patients are still struggling. So many patients, they gain weight during this time. Many prospect patients, many patients who were going through the process. So what would be the best way that we can actually manage it during these times? Even if it's slowing down, there are different things that patients can do. If you can just give us some education.
Absolutely, absolutely. So as you correctly said, Kemal, I would not be surprised if the nation's average body mass index has gone up by some units just because of the pandemic, right? The pandemic was almost like the perfect storm in terms of really getting people to gain weight. We are isolated, we are stressed, we have hoarded a lot of food, thinking that maybe food was not going to be available. We have more time to cook. We have more time to watch channels about food. And also the food is readily available to us, right? We're not going out. We're not going to work. And more importantly, also the opportunity for us to be physically active was limited because of the isolation as well, right? All that combined really led to a lot of people really even unconsciously to eat way more calories than they usually do and be less active than what they usually do. And that setup really leads to us gaining weight because we have a body that preferentially wants us to gain weight when the opportunity arises, right? It is very hard for us to lose weight when the opportunity arises, but it's very easy for us to gain weight when the opportunity arises, right? That's really the key problem that we have. That's why we struggle with obesity. And it was demonstrated during the pandemic perfectly because I saw it in my family, I saw it in my friends, I saw it in my patients. It was pervasive. So, and as we go forward, Kemal, what the advice I give to our patients is really to be conscious of this. Sometimes just being conscious of it is helpful, but it's difficult to be conscious every day. So you have to have some type of system that helps you with this. And you and I have talked about that. So what I very often talk about, Kemal, is to adopt what is called a time-restricted eating habit, which means that you schedule a certain window during the day, during that 24 hours, which you say to yourself, this is going to be the time for me to consume food, to consume calories, whether it's drinking calories, whether it's eating calories. You say to yourself, between this hour and this hour will be my eating window. Outside of that window, I will not be eating. I will just be having water or a water substitute. Now, that window can be narrow or large depending on your tolerance level, right? There is no set rule. But at least if you put that, it means that you're not going to be snacking mindlessly. And that's what hurts people most of the time, right? You are in your office working on the computer. Suddenly you have to go to the bathroom. You get up. And if the kitchen is on the way to go there, come on, you mm-hmm. are going to munch on something without any issues, right? Because we when we see food, that's what we do. Now, if you have this time-restricted eating schedule in your own schedule, say, okay, it's not time for me to eat, you will go to the bathroom, come back, and the chance for you to eat are going to be much less. So that's one important thing to adopt.
Now, the intermittent diet right now.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
I'm doing a modified one. We are doing the same, same intermittent diet, but we are doing it in different ways. So
yes.
Now for me, it's Monday through Friday.
Yeah.
And after 10 p.m., I may be lying a little bit, 10 p.m., I don't eat until like 7 p.m. Now, last couple of days, because I know that Anne and Anna are watching, that they're going to just call me out. So I got hungrier around like 5-ish. And then I was in the office, and it was already several hours, so I didn't have a problem. So I don't eat between 10 p.m. and 7 a.m. Like today, so it's almost 1:30. I got up around 6:45, 7, and have coffee, water, and other stuff I didn't eat. So now you do it differently.
Yes, yes. So I do it differently. I do actually, I include weekends as well. So what you and I do is a little bit more difficult for most people, Kemal. It's what they call a warrior's schedule, because we really spend several hours without eating. And to some extent, we got accustomed to it and we support each other on it. So we're able to really stick to it a lot longer. It may be hard for most people to adapt to this fully, but what they could do, Kemal, as I say, is to have windows in which they say to themselves, in these 24 hours, right, there will be a window in which I will allow myself to eat. That window could be from, you know, 10 a.m. until 5 p.m. It could be from 11 a.m. until 8 p.m. Or depending on when it is that they struggle most, they could allow themselves to eat during the period in which they struggle most and then not eat during the others. Really, the idea is for them to adapt this avoidance of mindless snacking, which is what gets a lot of people, Kemal, in our society, because the presence of food is so pervasive, right? Every table that we work on, every room that we walk through has some kind of snack, some kind of food. And we want to avoid that mindless increase in calories because they accumulate, you know. It takes an extra 100 calorie a day in 1 year for a person to gain 10 pounds in a year, Kemal, right? And then if they do that for 5 years, that's a big number, right? And that is just 100 extra calorie a day, right? Now, if you did the reverse, if you stopped eating 100 calories less a day, you wouldn't lose that much weight because, as I said, our body is much happier to gain weight than it is to lose weight. And that's our problem, right? So what we're saying is, yes, I mean, yeah, absolutely. It's called intermittent fasting, but intermittent fasting may be too much for most people, right? So what I talk to them about is about restricting the time in which they allow themselves to eat, right? Say, for instance, it could be even daytime. They could say after breakfast from 8 a.m. or 9 a.m. until 2, until 3 p.m., I will not allow myself to eat. I'll just have water. Well, they've taken a good chunk of the day out in which they could have been snacking, Kemal. So that, I think, helps greatly during the pandemic from that sense. And then the other thing that obviously is important is to move,